Plucking Strings.
Hey everybody, thanks very much for checking out my video. Today I'm going to show you how to play this awesome song off of Rush's Fly By Night album called By-Tor and the Snowdog. This is like Rush's first epic battle song, first of many that you'll hear out of their repertoire. So, little backstory that's kind of cool about this song. Rush's manager had two dogs, and whenever there were gatherings at his house, there was a German Shepherd that was almost guaranteed to give you a little nip if you weren't friendly to it. And then there was this other dog, very much smaller, a white dog, and he was always very nervous and just kind of sketchy. So his manager just called him By-Tor, German Shepherd, and the Snow Dog, the little nervous guy. And hence, that is where it came from, By-Tor and the Snow Dog. Of course, Neil then wrote this epic battle song that we now know and love. So if you get something out of this video, please feel free to share this with some of your friends, like it, and subscribe to my channel. And down in this area here, you'll see this little bell notification symbol. Why don't you go ahead and click on that, and therefore you will be notified every time I send out a new video. So anyways, let's go ahead and jump right on in, and let's get going. Alright, so here is the beginning of the song. I'm going to go ahead and play it for you, and then I will show you how to play it. So the beginning part, you are wailing away on the G chord, doing kind of this bass line down to A and then D. So you're going to be striking the G chord. If you're not familiar what the G chord is, put your pinky on your first string, third fret, third finger, second string, third fret, and your second finger on your sixth string, third fret, and you're going to be muting the fifth string with this finger. And you're going to be striking that four times. One, two, three, four. And then you're going to be taking your first finger, going down to your second fret, sixth string. One, two, three, four. So. And then from there, you're going to take your first finger and you're going to do the A chord. Now what I do, just to kind of keep it simple, is I keep my first two fingers here. From the G chord down here. So I go 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. And then straight to D four times. The cool thing is that this third finger is kind of like your anchor finger the whole time. So it'll hold all your fingers in place when you're doing the chord changes. And then after that, D, A, D, A. And then from there, you're still going to be doing the G chord with the bass line down, but now you're throwing everything up an octave. Still with the same shape, though. It's kind of cool. Where these two fingers were, you're going to be replacing those two fingers now with your third finger on your first string, third fret, and now your second finger on your second string, third fret. And you're going to be focusing on your four top strings, your 4, 3, 2, 1. And you're going to be hitting that four times. And now you're taking your pinky and put it on your fourth string, fourth fret. Hit that four times. And now your first finger, fourth string, second fret, four times. And then to D, four times. And then again, Now E. You repeat the first part again. By-Tor is C, F, G. F, G, D. Repeat. Next verse. During the second part where you're stressing the higher notes of that G chord, where you're replacing the two fingers, to help with the avoidance of these sixth and fifth strings, sometimes when I play it, I will kind of have my thumb wrapped around, muting those two strings. After the last time you do, the chords are E, A, B. And then G, back to your G chord. D, E. To a C sus 2 bar on your third fret. You're not going to play your sixth string, and put your third finger on your fourth string fifth fret, pinky on your third string fifth fret, and you're going to strike all five of these strings and then go to your G bar chord and then repeat again. Go back to A. Bum, 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 bum. So let's go ahead and play all those pieces together just one time through, though, even though in the song they repeat some of them sometimes. So. High three strings. So. Twice. And then from C to F. And instead of doing the whole bar chord F, what I do is take the chord C and then
when I go to F, what I'm doing is I'm shifting my second finger to my third string, and I'm putting my pinky down on the fourth string, third fret. And I do those changes twice. So C, C, and then for the next section, what I do is I take the C shape and I move it up a whole step. So two frets, one, two. And I do the exact same finger changing again, so. And the last chord I just hit there was E. It's a really full E chord. First finger, fifth string, seventh fret. Third finger, fourth string, ninth fret. Pinky, third string, ninth fret. All the other strings are open. So let's just start from the section where it has your E chord going from E to A to B. That's right when they go into that epic first battle scene between By-Tor and the Snowdog. So if you're familiar with the song, you will hear a bunch of echo. I believe they probably have some distortion on the bass, a lot of overdubbing, and a lot of chirps and squeals from the guitar. This is the only part of the song that I'm not going to transcribe. Sorry about that, guys. If you wanted that part of the song, it's not going to happen. It's just a little too epic. Anyways, I hope that you enjoyed the first part of By-Tor and the Snowdog. Check out the second part for the rest of the song, and you will hear some really cool lead guitar, and it's a great solo.